Extreme Edge, presented by Strike King.
Hi, I'm Denny Brauer. One of the simplest baits out there is just the good old jig, but yet it's undoubtedly the best bait, especially when it comes to catching big fish. But there's so many different styles of jigs. You know, we've got the structure jig now, we've got the football jig, and of course, several years ago, I designed the premier pro model jig for Strike King, and I really designed this jig for flipping and pitching. It is a very versatile bait because you can fish it in grass, you can fish it in wood, you can get in the brush piles, willow trees, whatever you want to do with this bait. It's designed to get in there and get back out without getting hung up. It's got a good strong weed guard. The way the head's shaped, it ensures a high percentage of hookups. We got a big strong hook in this thing to where you can fish it on braided line or fluorocarbon, whichever you prefer. And another neat thing about it, I've got a big rattle chamber in it. So when you put this thing in heavy cover and you sit there and you jig it up and down, it's actually making a sound that the fish are going to come to the bait. We've got it in a lot of colors, and be honest with you, I don't carry every color because you don't need it. I look at the water clarity when I get to the lake, and if the water's fairly clear, I like to go with this particular color. We call it number 46. It's actually a green pumpkin combination at Strike King. That's my clear water color. Now if I get there and say the water's dirty, I want something with, that's basically a dark jig, but with something bright in it, like chartreuse. So we got a color called a Texas crawfish that kind of fills the need for dirty water. In the stained water that maybe you could see 2 or 3 feet down into, which is water we encounter all over the country, I like black and blue, and that's probably why black and blue is such a popular color, because there's so much water clarity that's perfect for black and blue. But I will say this, if you're on a budget and you only want to buy one color, you probably need to buy black and blue, because it will work in clear water, it will work in muddy water, but it's at its best in that slightly stained water. As far as weights of jigs, majority of my tackle box is made up with 3/8 and 1/2 ounce jigs. For flipping and pitching, those two weights pretty well fill the bill. Docks can be just an excellent place to catch a lot of quality fish because they offer so much shade. A lot of bluegill get around them. But there's always key areas on these boat docks, and where you have a support post like that, that can be a great place because it goes all the way to the bottom and those fish will lay along there. So as you're fishing these docks, try to figure out the little things that are different where them bass may be laying. Really pay attention to that. And when you make the presentation, try to get it as close to the cover as you can and always let it fall straight to the bottom on a slack line and then ease into it. Feel if it's heavy or feels different. Once in a while, you just see your line start moving. Great, great technique for catching fish around boat docks. And you know, no matter what the cover is, the presentation is so key. And that's what's neat about flipping and pitching, is you can reach them places people can't reach casting. But always remember this, every presentation, your line should be having a little bit of slack in it so that the bait can fall straight to the bottom unimpeded. But you want to be focused on that line, because if it ticks, it jumps, it moves sideways, or does anything different, boy, you don't even check it, just jerk, because that fish has got it in his mouth. One other technique I will use some around boat docks, especially in the fall when they get suspended up underneath the flotation, it'll be a deal to where they're ambushing shad. They're just running out and grabbing those shad, and you make your pitch and you let your jig only sink a couple of feet, and then you just kind of swim it like this along underneath that flotation. And man, they'll just come out and whack. And a lot of times when I'm doing that and I'm trying to emulate a shad, I'll actually go to a white colored jig that actually resembles a shad and can be very, very effective that way. You want to become a better flipper and pitcher? You want to become a better big fish fisherman? Get yourself some Strike King Premier Pro Model jigs and you will get better.